Let's begin with the sensitive period for language. This sensitive period lasts the longest. It is from the age of birth all the way through about the age of six. And the reason that this sensitive period is the longest is because it is the most complex. This child has the absorbent mind that is supporting this process of acquiring language, creating language. It's the sensitive period that is giving focus to the child's work. Dr. Montessori observed the child having a sensitivity to sound, but not just any sound. It was the sound of the human voice. A child who is surrounded by sounds of, let's say, the city, does not replicate those sounds. The child replicates the sounds of the voices that are around them. The child is ready for language before they're even born. And there are studies that show that a child shows a preference to the language that they hear while they're in utero. During this time in the first plane of development, the child has the power to acquire any language and multiple languages. We use the term mother tongue for the child's very first language that they learn. This is the language that is actually integrated into the very fabric of who they are. During this time of language sensitivity, a child is not just acquiring and creating words. They're absorbing grammar, they're absorbing syntax, they are absorbing intonation of the words that are being used and the sentence structure that they hear. This truly is a window of opportunity for the child, and it only lasts for these first 6 years. Learning a second language as an adult, we know how difficult that is. And it's difficult because we don't have this gift of the sensitive period and of the absorbent mind working together. It is more laborious. And this will be the same for children once they leave that first plane of development. They will take more effort to learn another language. So being able to offer multiple languages if you can during that first plane of development is so important. So what would happen if the sensitive period for language closed before a child ever heard spoken language? Dr. Montessori was drawn to a study by Dr. Itard. It was called the Savage of Ave Rome, and it's also referred to as the study of the wild boy. The wild boy, who Dr. Itard named Victor, was found in a forest in France. He was about 12 years old, and he was mute. They assume that he had been living on his own since about the age of 2 or 3. This was a young person who had really never experienced language. So Dr. Itard's study was to see if he could teach Victor speech and how to communicate. Victor did learn how to speak, not very well, so this study was only mildly successful. But what this does show us is that language acquisition can happen after a sensitive period closes, but it is extremely difficult. The brain is hardwiring itself for language in the womb, and it continues this wiring as it hears language, as the child develops. Every child begins their journey to spoken language in the same way, and they follow the same patterns. And they start by observing. And around 4 months of age, you can see infants really watching the mouth of the person that is speaking to them. They are studying the lips, they are studying the mouth, they are studying the tongue. This is helping them prepare their own motor to get ready for speech. After the child observes the speaker for about 2 months, they start to animate their own organ of speech. And we hear that beautiful babbling happen, the ma, 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 pa, 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 right? And it's always a big celebration for the parents. Oh, they said mama. They're just really practicing their sounds, but we love it all the same. And it is nonetheless quite special. So we see a child around the age of 12 months or 1 year, use their first intentional word. This isn't just a word. This is an intentional word. It is a word with meaning. This is a huge leap in just 12 months to acquire language and then to understand language and to create language for communication. For the next 6 months, the child will be squirreling away vocabulary. They are absolutely hungry for words. They want to know the names of everything around them. They're practicing or mimicking the words that they're hearing. Then we see this two-year-old who can speak in short phrases or sentences that is successfully using intonation, starting to use elements of grammar. This is absolutely incredible. It's right around this age that the child is showing us that they are ready to tackle grammar and syntax. They are ready for more language, rich language. They are developmentally hungry for it. The Montessori Children's House is the perfect place for the child to be who's passing through a sensitive period for language. We consider the trained adult, you can call them the teacher, the Montessori guide, or the practitioner, to be the most important piece of language material in the classroom, because it's through the adult that this spoken language is being facilitated. I'm talking about telling stories and singing songs, having conversations with the child. We also are giving vocabulary to the child. There are so many items in our classrooms for the child to begin this process of categorizing and classifying information. This is growing their intelligence. And we have supports for the child from the ages of 2.5 to 3, all the way until the age of 6. There is absolutely no shortage of enrichment that we can offer this child.